Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about the difference between the any and the in operator in Postgres, how they differ in performance, and why you might use one or the other. We'll start with this blog post by Matt Hudson on the Crunchy Data blog. Matt gives a good introduction of how in lists are different than any lists. He has a query, and this query does a lookup on the ID column, and he's passing in 6 different values. He wants to use the SQL query in his application. He's using a Java application, the Vert.x Postgres library. He first tries to get this query into the application by using this in lists as he had initially in the query, and by using a $1 bind parameter. The goal here would be that you have one fixed query text, and then as your user supplied data is changing, you're passing this as a bind parameter, avoiding any SQL injection problems. This is generally a good idea. Now, he tries this and this fails. He gets an exception about the wrong number of parameters because he's passing in 6 values, but there's only a single bind parameter in this list. Now, he tries to, instead of sending in a list of values, sending in an array. This also fails with a different error because now Postgres is complaining that the ID column is an integer, but the $1 is an array, and that's mismatching. Matt reads up a little bit on how Postgres' in operator works. The in list is essentially a list of values, which means that you could write something like $1, $2 as separate bind parameters, and then it would actually work and it would match up with your bind parameters. But there's a better way. And so Matt comes to the any operator. Now the any operator looks very similar. So you're passing in $1 again, but instead of in, we're saying equals any. And what that means is if any of the $1 values in the $1 array are matched, then this is true. Otherwise, it's not true. This works and the bind parameter can be used successfully. The main argument that Matt makes here is that if you want to pass parameters securely, then it's a good idea to use equals any, because if you use in, you would have to generate the query text and that has a problem with potential SQL injections. Additionally, any also has some other features. For example, you can do comparisons with like or ilike or not. So you don't just have equal as an operator. You can be much more flexible. There is a question though, should I always be using one or the other? Back in 2017, Lucas Ader, who maintains the GOQORM, described how somebody reached out to him and asked why his ORM is using in lists and not any. They essentially said, this is slower, you should be using the faster version. Lucas did a benchmark. And the comparison he did was essentially the same thing that we just looked at, just looking at it from a performance perspective instead of from a security perspective. He has 2 statements, both pretty simple. And in one case, he's using an in list, in the other case, he's using an any with an array. Well, he runs it in a PLPG SQL function, which is a great way to make sure that we're testing the performance on the server side, not any kind of client interactions. The results here are, you know, we have a very short in list in this particular benchmark. It was actually faster to have an in list than any with an array. But once you get to a lot of values, so in his case, once you get to 128 values, then the array actually performs measurably better than the in list. Now, when I was looking at this, I remembered that there was actually a change in Postgres 14 that improved this. In the release notes, if you read them very carefully, there's a change that says allow hash lookup for in clauses with many constants. This is a patch by James Coleman that was committed by David Rowley. When you have a very long in list, it improves how efficient it is for Postgres to look up data in that in list. When James contributed this patch 2 years ago, what he was showing is that when he's passing 1,000 random integers in an in list, then with this patch in place, it's about 10x faster because there was something really inefficient with how Postgres was looking things up. So I think an important conclusion here is if you're not yet on Postgres 14 and you're using in lists, either out of choice or because your ORM generates them, then Postgres 14 will actually give you a nice performance boost for these long in lists. There is one other case that I want to mention, because I usually like to use equals any array, and there's one hazard that you have to watch out for, which is if you're using row type comparisons. In this example on a DBA stack exchange, somebody complained that their index was not being used when they were using equals any, but it was being used with the in operator. They were comparing A and B, and they were trying to match rows that had both of these equal to one of the reference values. In the case of equals any, it was doing a sequential scan, But in the case of in, it was doing index only scan. And long story short, the reason that this happens is mostly for internal reasons, but you can fix it by adding an explicit cast to the particular type in the index. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.